Well, the interesting thing with SaaS that people don't totally realize is the economies of scale are just so daunting that it's almost a force of gravity. We have 200 clients, so we're getting 200 times the resources in payment, basically, to invest in R&D versus someone who's trying to build it by themselves who would have to pay dollar for dollar. I think at this point, we're up to about $1.5 trillion of active closed loan AUM. That doesn't count pipeline or burned off deals. And I think we're somewhere around north of 1 billion data points. So homegrown systems are built from one perspective. We have the benefit of 200 clients' feedback and perspective versus a single company trying to build a system solely from one perspective. I don't want to be too hard on it, but there's a real problem, which is typically the internal tech team gets asked to do the build versus buy analysis. So basically, they'll look at other outside vendors, and then they will provide an estimate of how long it would take to build internally. The problem is they're basically saying whether or not they should keep their job. We get input on features from our 200 clients. And as a result, we can pick the best and the most important and understand a lot of people's perspective on how to build the optimal task or workflow or report versus someone having to try to write it by themselves in a corner with simply one person's perspective, which is really hard to do the first time. Excel and Word, amazing programs, but your data gets siloed on the desktop or on a C drive or a local Box drive, and the data does not get extracted and put into a centralized data store. And as a result, you cannot run analytics and reporting at a portfolio basis. Now, so we intentionally designed Rockport to be highly configurable, including all the way down into Excel, so that what your people are used to using, they can continue to use, but we can still extract all the data and put it into a centralized system.